Welcome to Looking Beyond Ourselves, a joint concert presented by University Choir and the World Music Ensemble. Today, we present to you a program of music that asks all of us to look beyond our own experiences to find new ways to connect and interface with the people and cultures that surround us. When we have a meaningful experience with a culture outside of our own, we are forever changed. Our first song is a mashup of two familiar tunes. We paint a picture of a utopia that exists out there somewhere. A place where trouble melts like lemon drops and beauty and harmony await each one of us. But sadly, the next song brings us back to reality. The harsh reality that people of color are disproportionately face violence and danger even by those who are meant to protect them. In Stardust, the singer calls for a home where we can run in memory of Ahmaud Arbery, a home where we can pray in the memory of the victims of the Mother Emanuel shooting, a home where we can breathe in memory of George Floyd, and a home to sleep and dream without fear in memory of Breonna Taylor. When we sing, we pray twice, and it is my prayer that this piece stirs all who hear it to call for justice for the people of color taken from this world before their time without concern for their humanity.
Thank you.
sopranos and altos from the University Choir are excited to sing for you Lineage by Andrea Ramsey. Sometimes we look beyond ourselves, we need to better understand our roots. From the composer's notes to the singers, and I quote, Margaret Walker's poem leapt off the page for me, these words requiring to be sung. I was drawn to the strength of the grandmothers described by Walker. This was not frailty, this was determined womanhood. In studying the music, I aim for an earthy at times or even bluesy feel. Not bluesy in the commercial sense, but in the heart and gut sense, end quote. The poem ends with a question, why am I not as they? The answer to the question may very well be that we are. We may just need a reminder of the strong woman who preceded us.
With veins rolling roughly over. Good afternoon. Langston Hughes is considered one of the most prolific and powerful African-American writers in the 20th century in American literature. His verses often reflect the experiences that spoke directly to society issues of his time, including politics, religion, and racial discrimination. I Dream a World encourages us to keep the dream alive that someday we can achieve not just equality, but justice. We all have a lot of work to do, and while Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote reminds us that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. For now, we continue to embrace the words of Langston Hughes and continue to dream a world where all will know sweet freedom's way.
Dream, I dream. Ensemble. And can you hear me now? Yes, okay, good. Good afternoon, and this is now the World Music Ensemble, and we've been working hard on pieces from various cultures throughout the world. And we're gonna start in Cuba, and we're gonna play a couple of pieces for you, starting with Chan Chan, and then Havana. And then after that, we're gonna move to Brazil. And then lastly, we're going to join with the choir, and we're gonna go to Africa. And then I think we're gonna conclude sort of the Caribbean. So I think we're ready. Our first piece for you tonight is, or this afternoon, excuse me, is Chan Chan. Thank you. And next, we're moving to Brazil to start with La Grota de Ipanema, or you guys know that song as The Girl from Ipanema. And then we'll be concluding with Mas Que Nada, a very, very well-known piece.
Thank you.
They're so shy. They're so shy. We have two seniors who are participating in this great schlep here for World Music Ensemble, so I will wait for them. But I will start by saying thank you. Thank you for coming out and spending the afternoon with us. It's so nice to see such a full house, even on such a beautiful day. So thank you for coming inside and living in the windowless environment that musicians spend so much time in. But it's where we find so much joy. Just wanted to take an opportunity to say thank you to my colleagues here in the music department, to Chad and Albert, who provide technical support for us here in Arts 111 and in the Arts Building in general. And a huge thank you to my colleague, Randy Griswold. Randy is a lecturer here at Cal State San Marcos. He teaches intro to music, music appreciation, but also he teaches world music. That should not come as a surprise, in addition to the World Music Ensemble. So this is only my second year here. Randy has been here much longer, but we started talking about this last year about how it would be nice to get the two groups together and make some music together. So this is the first time that choir and World Music Ensemble have done a concert together, and now you will see them actually make music together as well. So that was lots of fun.
A big thank you to the students in World Music Ensemble. My office is right up there, so I get to hear the beats that they're working on in my office. So it's always fun to hear that come together through the floor and then get to hear it in person too. And a big thank you to my choir, who has put in a lot of work this semester as well, and in some different environments and having to be a little bit more flexible than maybe we are accustomed to. And we're an off-the-score kind of group, and World Music Ensemble is not. So we made it work, So just a moment to recognize some graduating seniors. We're going to do this in whatever order you probably filled out the survey online. So first and foremost, we have Felicity. Please come up. This is my favorite and least favorite thing to do, is to recognize seniors. Of course, we love seeing them graduate, but we're also always a little sad to see them go. Felicity has been in choir for 4 years, and she is a music major. After graduation, she is going to continue to write music, take her work to the studios, and also plan to keep performing and getting her name out there. Her favorite song that we've done is Lineage, the one that you have heard today. And advice for first and second year students. If you experience self-doubt, know it is a sign of yearning. If you find yourself asking, am I really a musician? Am I good enough? The chances are you are. The counterfeit creator is self-confident. The real one is scared to death. Congratulations, Felicity. Next we have Caitlin. Caitlin and I have the same tenure here in choir, 2 years, at Cal State San Marcos, and her major is Criminology and Justice Studies with a minor in theater. After graduation, she plans to find a big girl job and have fun. Me too. Her favorite song is Follow the Drinking Gourd. That's been a big hit. Lots of favorites with that one. And advice, get involved and step out of your comfort zone. You never know what you love if you never try new things. Congratulations, Caitlin. Next up is Jan. Jan predates me, 4 years in choir here at Cal State San Marcos. His major is computer science and also music. After graduation, he will be going to a commission with the Navy. His favorite song is Dirépons, a French tune. And good advice from Jan, don't let life bring you down. It gets more bearable with good company. Congratulations, Jan. Next up is Grace. Only 1 year in choir, tisk tisk, but I'm glad you came when you did. Majoring in history. After graduation, Grace is going to work at CSUSM in COBA, the College of Business, until she starts her teaching credential in the fall. Yes, applause for teaching. Her favorite song was Stardust. Advice, take choir. If only past you had taken this advice. Take choir as perhaps your first opportunity to think as a unit. Not one better than the other, but all working to sound good as one. Ask for help when you need it, and sometimes when you don't. Think of how you can help others. Congrats. Next, we have Armando de Jesus Santos Valdez López. Two years in choir, and Armando is a music major. After graduation, his first answer was that he's going to nap. When I asked for more, he said to live la vida loca and continue being a knowledge seeker. His favorite song was Alchemy, a piece we did in the fall. His advice is take this time to grow spiritually, personally, mentally, and push yourself to do things that take you out of your comfort zone. Lastly, to have fun, but don't get caught. XOXO Gossip Girl. I don't even know what that means. And next we have Aaron Wilson. Transferred in from way, way, way far south. Actually, it's not that far south. I guess it's far east. Her major is music. After graduation, she hopes to teach as well as perform as much as she can. She's going to apply to graduate school. A big goal of hers is to teach music at the university level so that she can pour into her students like her professors did. Her favorite song is Stardust, and her advice is find something you are passionate about and stick with it. It makes the hard work worth it all. And Will. We're gonna have to do this interview style. How many years have you been at Cal State San Marcos? Okay, we can leave it at that. And your major is?
Music.
Just music? Just music. Okay. After graduation, what are you going to do?
Going to SDC for grad school.
Keeping it in the Cal State fam. What's your favorite song in this concert?
Girl from Ipanema. It's just one that I played the longest and I know.
Classic. It's classic. Do you have any advice for our first and second year students?
Be the reason you love music.
Congratulations, Will. Thank you. Well, we're gonna wrap it up with a set of three South African songs. We'll get a more formal introduction of those in just a moment, and then we will close the concert with a piece called Iko Iko, which comes from the Creole tradition. Is popular as part of many celebrations that you will find in Mardi Gras down in New Orleans. And as I do know that today is May 5th, Cinco de Mayo, I just want to remind my students to make good choices. Thank you for being here tonight.
Like many countries in the world, the nation of South Africa is made up of indigenous tribes along with Westerners and their descendants. The nation of South Africa is a product of colonization and a victim of apartheid, one of the cruelest and most overt implementations of systemic racism. In the face of oppression, music has long served as an outlet to lift the spirits, to be a healing balm, and fan the small embers of hope for a better tomorrow. Around the world, folk music shares many hallmarks, including call and response singing, short melodic cells that are developed over time, and singable melodies. Traditionally taught by rote, we hope you'll leave humming these tunes today. We will sing the following songs. Here are brief translations. Kululu Mbadaba, sung in Zulu. Hey you, take off your shoes. Kwangena Tinabo, sung in the Xhosa language. When we entered the room, it was quiet. But then they began to praise us as a great choir. Shosholoza, an Nguni song sung in the Zulu and in the Bembe languages. Hold the train that leaves for South Africa. I want to get on.